Hello everyone, this is Kieran
and Nicholas reporting to you from SJYM News.
We're here to investigate the reports that after a brutal crucifixion, Jesus' body has actually disappeared from the grave.
He is alive. He's not in a tomb. We have several eyewitnesses who say they have seen Jesus since he has died. Here with us today, we have three women who were close to Jesus. They were the first to see the tomb empty, Mary Magdalene, and Joanna.
First we have Mary, the wife of Cleopas. Mary, you and your husband were longtime followers of Jesus. Can you tell us what you saw when you went to the tomb?
We saw him die on the cross, you know. We were there with Jesus' mother, Mary, at the foot of the cross when Jesus died. It was horrible. We thought we'd never see him again. We went to the tomb because we were very sad. We loved him so much. We saw the big entrance stone move back, so we walked into the tomb. We looked around. We didn't see his body anywhere. Our Lord was gone! We thought his body had been moved to another place.
Now we turn to Mary Magdalene. Mary Magdalene, you were following Jesus for some time during his ministry. Some even say you were like one of the disciples. Tell us what you saw.
We were sitting there trying to think about what to do, when out of nowhere it seemed we saw two men with bright light shining out of them. I stood there and thought they must be angels. They asked us what we were looking for, and we said we were looking for Jesus. Do you know where they have taken him? And the angel said, "Why would you look for the living amongst the dead? He's not here." But it raised him up just like he said he was going to do.
Now Joanna, wife of Chusa, household manager of King Herod Antipas, no less. Wow! You too were a follower of Jesus' ministry, as were many other women, as I understand it. Tell us what you experienced.
When we saw the angels at the tomb, we were so excited. We went to tell the others what had happened, but they didn't believe us. We kept telling them, but the guys didn't believe it at all. They didn't believe that the tomb was open and that Jesus wasn't there, that he had risen. They thought we were making it all up. Then, all of a sudden, Peter jumped to his feet and ran to the tomb to see for himself. Peter and Jesus were like best buds, you know. He got there and looked inside for Jesus, but all he saw were a few grave clothes. That's all that was left in the tomb. No Jesus, just as we had said. Peter couldn't believe it either. No one could believe it.
I understand that on the same day, two of Jesus' disciples were walking along the road to Emmaus.
Cleopas, we've heard the testimony of your wife Mary when she visited the tomb with Mary Magdalene and Joanna, and they found it empty. Would you tell us about your unusual experience?
Yes. Tell us, gentlemen, what happened?
Well, we were walking along and talking about all the things that had happened. And then this guy came up to us. We didn't recognize him at all. He asked us what we were talking about, and we just stood there sad because we had lost our best friend. We told him that he was a man of God, and that he was sentenced to death, died on the cross, and was laid in a tomb. And earlier this morning, some women went by the tomb and found it empty. We're confused and don't know what to make of this.
We were walking for a long time, and we were very tired and hungry. So we asked the stranger to stay and have supper with us. And an amazing thing happened. The stranger sat down with us, he took the bread, he blessed it, and he broke it, and then he gave it to us all. Suddenly, at that moment, during the breaking of the bread, we knew that it was our Lord Jesus.
We sat there with our eyes big and our mouths open, and then he just disappeared. Afterward, we talked about how we both felt on fire when he spoke to us.
We should have known it was Jesus.
Wow, this is an amazing story. We have even more eyewitnesses. Later that day, the disciples went into a house and locked the doors.
Andrew was one of the disciples who were in the house that day. Andrew, tell us what happened when you were in the house.
Well, we were all together in the house when we saw that Jesus was standing right there beside us. We couldn't believe our eyes. We started jumping up and down and cheered. We were so happy. Our Lord was alive. Then he took a deep breath and breathed on us. He said, "Receive the Holy Spirit." Thomas wasn't there to see all of it.
Thomas, tell us about your experience with the risen Lord.
About a week later, we were all in a room together again. The doors were all locked. This time, I was with the disciples. I couldn't believe what they had told me, that they'd seen Jesus, alive. Then Jesus himself walked right through the wall, right through locked doors, and stood there with us. Jesus seemed to understand my confusion and told me to come closer to him, to look at his hands and feet. "It's really me," he said. He looked at me and said, "Take your hand and stick it in my side. Believe." Jesus asked if there was anything to eat, like he was hungry. We gave him a piece of leftover fish, and he took it and ate it right there. I knew then it was really him. It was our Lord, risen from the dead. I said, "My Master, my God." And then Jesus said, "You believe because you've seen with your own eyes. Even better blessings are in store for those who believe without seeing." It really is a mystery.
Better blessings are in store for people who believe without seeing. That's me! Let's see who else saw the risen Lord.
This story just gets more and more interesting. After this, Jesus appeared again to the disciples, this time at the Tiberias Sea.
Peter, tell us what happened.
Well, we had been fishing all night long, but we hadn't caught any fish. We were tired and cold and wanted to go home. Just as the sun came up, we saw a man standing on the beach. We didn't know who it was. He called to us, asking if we had caught any fish. We told him we hadn't caught any all night long. He told us to put the net off the other side of the boat. We did what he said, and we caught 153 big fish. The net was so heavy, we could barely carry it. Then we went to the shore, and we saw that the stranger was standing there beside a fire with bread and fish cooking. It looked so good because we were really hungry. Then he said, "Come and eat. Breakfast is ready." We didn't want to ask him who he was, but then Jesus took the bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to us. Then we knew for sure who it was. It was our Lord Jesus. It was in the breaking of the bread that we knew for sure it was our Lord Jesus.
We have with us another disciple who will tell us about the last time he saw Jesus.
Later, we disciples went to the Galilee, to the mountains where Jesus told us to go. When we saw him, we worshipped him. But some of us still doubted, you know? It was amazing. And Jesus came and said to us, "All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." He is with us always!
So it seems there's no way to dispute all this evidence.
Uh-oh, here's a message coming through. What? Jesus? Lord of Lords? Rising? Heaven? Hundreds of eyewitnesses? Be right there.
Jesus died, was buried, and rose from the dead, and now ascended to heaven.
Can you believe it?